internal government reforms. Reforms in civil service forces, city officials move to rural areas. Another spring for Kazakhstan's opposition. The Kazakh opposition is getting ready for another spring cleaning. Bulat Abilov speaks up. Blood, sweat, and tears. What does the Russian gallery owner Marat Helman wants to find in the contemporary art of Kazakhstan? Kazakh artist Kanat Ibrahimov explains why love is impossible.
Hello,
I'm Asylbek Abdulov and you're watching Vlast KZ on K+. First, let's take a look at some of the people who surprised us last week. The first deputy chair of the ruling party Nuratan Bauržan Baybek was busy explaining to the population the real meaning behind the recent utility tariffs raise. Apparently, everything is done for the people's benefit. During his meeting with the Almaty youth, Baybek said that the higher rates will teach people to save more, because that is what he did while studying in Germany as part of the Balashak exchange program. When I studied in Germany, there were times when utility company reps came to their neighborhood to check whether tenants are still alive. The bills were just that minuscule, but it would always be some old lady just saving on everything. She'd wash dishes first, and then use the same water to mop the floor. People there also reuse water to bathe kids and later adults. If we raise the rates, people will use less water and will likely pay less. We just keep wasting water, electricity and paper. All the while we have to be saving our resources. All that is wasted now goes right to the account of our children and future generations. In Germany, people turn off their radiators at night and monitor the water temperature. When it starts to freeze, they turn on the heating. In the morning, you get up feeling tired and frustrated when it's hot in the room. But when it's cold, you rest better because the body temperature drops. Low body temperature causes the human body to relax. In response, the internet community exploded with quite an insightful criticism and ruthless trolling. Here's what people had to say to the new deputy chair of Nuratan. It would be quite fun to mop the floor with the greasy dishwashing water. I propose to extend the list with the rule of no flushing the toilet unless all family members use it, and eat only once a week while adults eat only after the children. That's right. If you buy less groceries, you eat less, rarely wash your dishes and hands. That causes the metabolism to slow down. Subsequently, you use the toilet less, sweat less, and wash yourself less. Actually, I would like to propose our officials to flush the water used multiple times, not into the sewage system, but into their pools. That would be a great economy. Perhaps Mr. Baybek is not aware that in some parts of Kazakhstan, there is not enough water, if any. It's like telling to a starving man about the benefits of the diet. Maybe he, as an influential person, could answer the basic questions that concern many Kazakhstan citizens. Why in the country which exports energy, utility rates rise disproportionately fast? We understand that pipes wear out with the time, and they need to be repaired and replaced. However, it is not clear why the ruling party, which has been in power for 20 years, headed by Baybek, did not even bother to think about it. It is interesting, does he personally do that? Does he wash dishes, then himself, and later his wife with kids, the floor, the car, and flushes what is left? That's idiotism. You should better try to save up on all sorts of meaningless summits, meetings, and acquisitions, and stupid nationalization of banks such as BTA, and maintenance of palaces. In math, you have a simple concept such as proportion. Instead of forcing families to pay hefty utility bills, you must give them a chance to pay these bigger bills without affecting the family budget much. You should better not teach people how to save up like that, but instead, you should cut your spending habits while you live off the taxes of these people. It seems that the utility innovations of the party's first deputy chair quickly killed all the efforts to recover public trust in the current government. Following his recent appointment, Bauržan Baybek identified rebuilding public trust as the key priority for Nuratan. The party wants public affection, a mission most likely doomed as the population forced to save always chooses to save on its trust in the authorities. After all, the public's respect and love for the government must be kept at the equal ratio to what the government offers to its citizens.
Быть экономными и по расчету, то есть адекватными чувствам которые испытывает Казахстан.
Another alumnus of the Balashak exchange programs, first generation Габидолла Абдрахимов, also wants to improve public trust in the authorities through reforms in the civil service. The deputy head of the president's administration talks about amendments to the law on civil service, which will come into effect on March 26.
Руководителя президентской администрации имеет в виду обновленный закон о государственной службе.
As part of said reforms, 5,000 white collars will be sent from Astana to serve in regional administrations.
В региональные акиматы отправятся служить 5000 клерков из Астаны.
The history teacher Anerbek came to work to his village within the scope of Jasatan program upon receiving a degree from Jetesu University. This is his third year of teaching at Jambul village of Koksu district in Almaty region. The 25-year-old teacher managed to become the best young specialist in the area. Anerbek received a one-time financial aid as a participant to the state program to the village with diploma, and he could also take a loan for a house with an interest rate of less than 1%. I decided not to take the load because my father already had a house in the village. I received around $1,000 as the resettling benefit. There aren't enough doctors in the area and many people with poor health. Due to the fact that there are almost no industry in the rural areas, only doctors and teachers are coming to the village under Jasatan program. Anerbek teaches in a small school with a total of 100 students. Not much working hours reflect on his salary. Therefore, a history teacher has a part job in the public school of Taldykorgan. The state program to the village with diploma was initiated in 2009. Per official data, over 2,000 graduates have moved to rural areas for the past 4 years. Currently, there is a plan to send 5,000 officials from Astana to the villages as well. This project was initiated by the presidential administration. They believe that relocating civil servants from Astana to work in the regional district and village local administrations will make them closer to people. Besides, their relocation will contribute towards a breakthrough in the social and economic development in the villages. I support the idea that officials will gain experience by moving to the regions. That is good. This will help them to learn the real situation in the country. No need to hide it. There is an issue of tribalism in our country. For instance, a newly appointed mayor in any region chooses a powerful man from this very region as his deputy, because the locals don't recognize the newcomers. I believe that this new initiative will help eradicate this practice. Any citizen of Kazakhstan, whoever he is, should be able to work in any region of the country. There are no jobs. Why would there be any if there is no production, no local industry and no agriculture product processing? Baltar Tursunbaev, the former deputy prime minister, former minister of agriculture and the former mayor, knows firsthand about the situation in the regions. He's convinced that this project is a waste of time and money. Following the events in Zhanaozen, authorities are trying to establish a dialogue with the people. Hence the newly established Ministry of Regional Development and relocation of 5,000 officials. Whereas the civil servants from Astana will only increase the bureaucracy in the regions, says Tursunbaev. Local authorities won't recognize the newcomers. It will only be a waste of time. I believe they'll be selling each other out, just like informers in 1935. They will file denunciations against one another, whereas the capital will have to take appropriate actions. Perhaps they applied the divide and conquer principle, having two groups, local officials and newcomers. Amanbek is very proud of these 3 hectares of apple grove. He planted the trees 3 years ago. There is a variety of apples. This year the apple trees should bring the first crop. The experienced farmer says that there is always work in the village for those who actually want to work. However, there certainly won't be an office job. The local people hold their own farming. It's not a bad living working for yourself. They grow sugar beet and vegetables on the land plots. The local authorities are generally in charge of landscaping and collecting land and harvest taxes. There are only 7 people working in the local administration office, and like Astana, there are no drivers provided. The local staff complains that there are not enough jobs for local residents in their area, therefore the officials coming from Astana are only going to cause the unemployment. I don't think that villages actually need the new officials. We have one city administration covering 4 villages. There are 4 schools with no vacant positions. All jobs are taken. I believe that local residents should be in charge because they know the people and they are well aware of all the problems. Meanwhile, Akorda doesn't specify when the relocation of Astana officials will take place. Apparently, where there is a will, there is a way. So 5,000 civil servants will have no problem finding jobs. Perhaps their arrival will finally initiate the road repairs and infrastructure improvement in the villages. This may give the local residents something to be grateful for.
For an entire decade, Kazakhstan's government has been delaying the decision on the introduction of elections for local administration heads. Said norms are included in the constitution, but were never implemented, remaining an unfulfilled promise. The first time the leader of Public Association Democratic Choice of Kazakhstan reminded the president about the matter way back in November 2011. Since the country has chosen to develop in the market economy, meaning there is competition in all areas of the economy, while where there is a monopoly, it is regulated by an appropriate body, such as an anti-monopoly agency. The same should apply in politics. There should be political competition so that the population would have a chance to choose alternative platforms, local and regional leaders, as well as be able to adjudicate the quality of their work, as opposed to the situation where the population has no ability to affect those in power, which in turn breeds apathy and lack of initiative. Only when the population has the ability to affect the process will there be a breadth of views. The people's demand, our nation's demand, is one and the same. Local leaders should be elected and hence accountable to the nation itself. It is important for the nation to control its own destiny, its own country, beginning with small villages, towns and regions. Only then will we see the results of our local self-government. Back then, Democratic Choice had five main goals: the extension of the parliament's powers, introduction of elections for local administration heads, reforms in the electoral and judicial systems, and finally the demonopolization of media. It was the end of 2001, the time when the first decade of Kazakhstan's independence was coming to an end.
Времени, когда завершалось первое десятилетие независимости Республики Казахстан.
In his interview to K+, Azad Party leader Bulat Abilov shared his thoughts about the goals of the Democratic Opposition in 2013, as well as reintroduction of past and new party agendas.
В интервью нашей программе рассказал лидер партии Азад Булат Абилов.
Мы считаем, что все важные, судьбоносные для страны вопросы должен решать народ.
We believe all the important and vital national issues should be addressed by the people. The world hasn't come up with a better practice. If we don't have a government that is representative of us Kazakhstanis, if there were fair elections with 3 to 5 parties that stood for the interests of the country's population, there may have not been discussions of a referendum. We believe the following are vital issues: the customs union, elections of local leaders, return of natural resources and strategic enterprises to the people of Kazakhstan. We are also against construction of a nuclear power plant and a nuclear fuel bank. What we want to say is that there are many of us who are not indifferent in this country. Sure, we may be pressed, persecuted, shut down, and imprisoned, but we were here, are here, and will remain here. We want to say, let's confer, let's discuss, let's talk. Unlike situations where there is an order from the top to execute, it is important for the population to understand this is our country, our destiny, our responsibility. I repeat that Nazarbayev's rule is but a fleeting moment in the history of Kazakhstan. We will be left to deal with a customs union, or a Eurasian union, or God forbid some other political organization. We will be left to deal with, excuse me, those from the offshore zones, your Mashkeviches, Kims, or someone else. We will be left to deal with nuclear power plants, nuclear fuel banks. I'm sorry, but I disagree. We scheduled a meeting for March 16th at the Kazakh Concert Hall. The building was rented, an agreement was signed, money was paid out. We hope we won't be turned away. The second issue is that around 40 people will be arriving from every region. The tickets were bought, flight numbers are known, hotels are booked. We have resolved all the organizational questions and are now at the finish line. This is a serious and vital matter, so we, as responsible people, want to say that we have finished 90% of our work. But the fact that the authorities are reacting to our offers is undeniable. He was forced to announce on December 14th that we will elect local leaders. This is clearly a crooked scheme using Nur Otan's local leadership. But can we not make a small town, village, or settlement elect its own leader? Can we not do so in Almaty, Astana, and 14 regional centers? Let's start and see what happens. We may start cleaning streets in a timely manner. We might construct better quality roads. There are many unresolved issues. Tariffs may stop growing at the current pace because local authorities are not interested in making the people pay less. On the contrary, they may be in the pocket of monopolists that control the public utilities market, doing business with them or somehow tied to them otherwise. The local authorities may have helped their nephew get a job, notwithstanding the violations. To this day, over the last 20 years, we haven't used our human capacity. Oil, gas, copper, speeches, percentages, growth. I'm sorry, but where's the human capital? It's still unrealized. Decisions are made by one person, by Nur Otan. by a regional leader. It's silly. Where in a European country or the United States will you find a villager write a letter to Obama? They have a very powerful local authority that addresses problems on the spot. In our country, any problem requires a letter to the president. Other countries elect local authorities. Here, they're appointed. What does that mean? It means they paid for their posts. Sometimes regional leaders are appointed through bribery. It means that this person will work for his or her own benefit and the benefit of the official he bribed, who will be running the show. In addition, he or she will try to earn back the money he or she spent. They all know they're temporary workers that will stay afloat for a maximum of 3 years. We must hold a meeting with 30 members from each regional center, including Almaty and Astana. The meeting will organize an initiative group consisting of 3 people from each region and district. The initiative group registers everything that goes on in the country. We adopt a document focusing on 4 issues and address it to the Central Electoral Committee. The committee must review the meeting's capacity, whether 30 members from each region were in attendance. An initiative group was indeed formed, and the issues brought up do not violate the Constitution of the Republic of Kazakhstan. If everything is done correctly, the election committee must hand us signing sheets, and our task is to collect 200,000 signatures across the country. Afterwards, the committee must establish that the 200,000 signatures are valid and pass them on to the president, who has to schedule a referendum. As for the party, the issue stands unresolved. We know that Jarmahan Tuyakbai scheduled an NSDP Congress for March. Let him do so. I will refrain from comments for the time being.
Смотрите во второй части передачи «Власть Киев». Next on «Власть Киев». События недели, хроника, факты, комментарии.
Blood, sweat and tears. What does the Russian gallery owner Marat Helman wants to find in the contemporary art of Kazakhstan? Kazakh artist Kanat Ibrahimov explains why love is impossible.
Мы продолжим наш обзор.
Stay with us, Власть КЗ. We'll return with more in a couple of minutes.
Власть КЗ.
Главные события в Казахстане. Достоверные факты. Эксклюзивные комментарии. Читайте в Казахстане информационно-аналитический портал «Республика». Чтобы обойти блокировки, воспользуйтесь доменом republikas.info. Вы окажетесь на так называемом прокси-портале. Специально разработанные канадскими специалистами по интернет-технологиям, прокси-порталы помогают пользователям получать информацию в тех странах, где блокируют интернет-ресурсы. В Китае, Иране, в Казахстане. Вы принимаете условия использования системы и попадаете на страницу информационно-аналитического портала «Республика». Материалы интернет-портала также доступны пользователям всемирной сети Facebook. facebook.com/republika.kaz. Если вы хотите поделиться информацией, вам есть что рассказать, звоните в редакцию «Республики». Наши телефоны в Казахстане +7 727 273 92 95, в Москве +7 495 621 87 03.
Новости Казахстана на казахском языке смотрите в 21:00 и далее каждый нечетный час. Новости Казахстана на русском языке в 22:00 и далее каждый четный час. Новости Казахстана на английском языке смотрите в 16:30, 17:30, 18:30 и 19:30 со вторника по субботу. Время Астаны. Изготовление и размещение рекламы на канале К+.
Международный женский день. Нурсултан Назарбаев.
Celebrating March 8th, International Women's Day, President Nazarbayev revealed which women he considers the most beautiful in the world. Inspired by the gloomy German genius Chancellor Otto von Bismarck, Nazarbayev said that the most beautiful women are the ones who give birth to a lot of children. The social policy of Kazakhstan's government currently coming into effect is evidently contradicting Nazarbayev's and Bismarck's view. The reduction of maternity benefits have caused outrage in the community. Amendments to the law on social security came into effect on February 17th and are seen by many as anti-popular.
Завершение выпуска. Видеокартинки с выставки.
Coming up next, we have an expose about the role of contemporary art as a whole, as well as individual artists in the context of culture and freedom. The art community always finds itself at eternal conflict with the autocracy, which never allows for any personal freedoms, just like the culture of protest.
Свободы с очень давних времен и культуры протеста.
Art group Kızıl Traktör dedicated its ethnic performance to the memory of Moldakul Narimbetov, who created the group more than 20 years ago. In February last year, the artist Narimbetov passed away. He lived a really hard life. He toiled away and left nothing for himself. He worked for us, for you and for the people. Shymkent art group Kızıl Traktör, that was previously known as Transavagant, will be on display in Perm, Russia. There are real installation masters, sculptures made from automobile tires and bars have been displayed at many art exhibitions. Marat Helman, the renowned Russia's gallerist, came to make arrangements for the display with Almaty officials. We just arranged it, and Kızıl Traktör is not even aware of it. We want to invite them to Perm in June for the White Night Festival and set up a Kızıl Traktör area where they could display their items. Moldakul Narimbetov is loved and respected in Perm. Helman personally knew Moldakul Narimbetov. He used to display the works of Kazakhstan artists at his exhibitions in Russia. Helman is always welcome in Kazakhstan, and his presence gives people hope for the rebirth of local contemporary art. I love Kazakhstan artists. For instance, Sasha Brenner from Almaty, he used to be a very bright artist in Moscow. I organized the first exhibitions of Yerbol Meldibekov in Italy and Moscow. I feel I have connection with Kazakhstan. Under the patronage of Helman, around 20 Kazakhstan artists were displayed at last year's White Night Festival in Perm. He did what other art curators in Kazakhstan could never do. He brought the works of artist Ibrahimov named Love is Impossible to Russia. The video footage of Zhanaozian's shooting is shown between two skulls made with the use of leaf gold. Ibrahimov's works are referred to as outrageous and scandalous in his homeland. However, Helman believes they're nothing but art. If a gesture has more meaning than the deed itself, I consider it art. When the group called War drew a penis on the bridge in St. Petersburg, I saw that artistic gesture was more meaningful than the deed itself that can be considered as minor offense. For me, this was art. If a group of people turns over a car and sets it on fire, I don't consider it art, because there is no artistic gesture and the deed is significant. Having organized a number of contemporary art exhibitions during the past year, Helman received several anonymous messages, including video messages with threats for his life and work.
Винзавод закрыл ворота. Ни тебе вина, ни тебе завода.
Helman has come up with simple ways to respond to attacks. One of the installations at the winery is called Cossacks Spit at Helman. Everyone may come and press a button spraying Helman's face with water. Contemporary art and modern society is in a similar type of relationship today. Ibrahimov supports the curator, saying that all attempts to hush down struggling artists will not be successful. There will be many people who will try to parasite the subject, but there are no protesting or politicized artists now. I want to stress that nomadic issues, LGBT and pseudo-Marxism that many artists are trying to use in their works are merely positioning in contemporary art. Kanat Ibrahimov views contemporary art as an open and straightforward protest. He's certain that only artists who are not in conflict with the government will be promoted. The art critic Valeria Ibraeva thinks that it's all about creating an artistic metaphor. At the post-mortal exhibition of Moldakul Narimbetov, his colleagues said that the artist disguised his protest in colors. Gray or bloody colors or ash-gray tones in the work of the artist symbolize destruction. Valeria Ibraeva says that all images of Narimbetov's works are clear and readable. This work shows Kerige turning into bloodstains. This is rather a readable image. If we talk about difficulties in understanding, the person who comes to an exhibition needs to use his brains and make a small effort in order to communicate with the artist. The opportunity for people to talk to the artist and for an artist to communicate with public is given for the first time after a turbulent 90s. The art critic Ibraeva says that there is an increasing interest to Kazakhstan contemporary art. She refers to Perm as an example. It turned from cultural province to the center of contemporary art thanks to Marat Helman's efforts. Democracy in art can be attained by change of dictators. It means that power needs to be in the hands of one person, but this person needs to be replaced every year, meaning one dictator can rule for 1 year, then another dictator takes over. It is not yet clear whether this approach will work in Almaty, however, the idea of changing dictators has an artistic message. Art is the most flexible and always quickly responds to the public mood.
В заключение мы поздравляем вас, дорогие и милые женщины, и ваших мужчин.
In conclusion, allow us to extend spring holiday greetings to all the beautiful women in the audience, and of course to their men. We wish you all the best, as well as a rejuvenation of your bodies and souls. Goodbye.
Это была программа «Власть.кз». Всего вам доброго и до новых встреч.